Hi everyone, I am Beatrice. In today's video, we'll look at some common herbal medications. You know, NCLEX is a test of safety, and some of these herbal medications have a lot of drug-drug interaction with other medications that will be prescribed by the healthcare provider. So it's important you note some of these medications that are commonly tested in NCLEX. If you are new to this channel, please go ahead, hit the subscribe button. Let's begin. So the first medication we're going to know is Ginkgo Biloba. This medication is used for memory. This medication is also used for intermittent claudication because it promotes blood circulation. So it's also used in peripheral vascular insufficiency. Whenever there's like obstruction in the veins where the blood is not able to flow properly. So it's believed that this medication, when given, it helps to, the mode of action is to help clear up those things and promote vessel dilation. The key point you need to know about Ginkgo Biloba is the increased risk for bleeding. And that's because of drug-drug interaction with other medication like anticoagulant, like e.g. warfarin, antiplatelet like aspirin, even NSAIDs. So any of those medications, they will ask a question, in NCLEX, they may ask a question related to that. They may say patient is taking anticoagulant or is taking NSAIDs, and the patient also report taking Ginkgo Biloba. What are some of the things you need to watch out for to, you know, assess in the patient? Is that increased risk for bleeding? And that's also a teaching point for the patient. It's also important that it can increase sedation when given with trazodone. And also it can increase blood glucose, especially when given with diuretics like azides. Now this next medication is St. John's Wort. This medication is used for depression, for anxiety, for neuralgic pain. So to help you remember this, just think of the word St. John. You know, most time when you look at, think about, or you hear St. this and that, it's associated with a church. So picture when, if you go to a church and you're dancing, that depression, that mood, you may feel that relief at that point. So you can use that to remember St. John's Wort, that is for depression, it's for anxiety. Those things you wear off if you are in a place where you are dancing and you are active. So the key point for St. John's Wort is that this medication interacts. In fact, St. John's Wort interacts with many medications. That is commonly tested in NCLEX because the interaction level is so much. It decreases oral contraceptive. You need to know this. So they may ask a question like a patient taking oral contraceptives and the patient is also on St. John's Wort. So you want to watch out for that because it's going to decrease that effect. Also, it also interacts with warfarin. All those anticoagulants, it interacts with anti-epileptics, it interacts with the gozin, the fedipine, chemo draws, even cyclosporine, theophylline, antidepressant. These medications and just what have a lot of drug-drug interactions. So when you see in exam and they are talking about the patient taking medication and is on St. John's Wort, you just be thinking about that interaction. One important thing you need to know, if they are taking it with antidepressant, it can lead to serotonin syndrome. And in serotonin syndrome, where there is excessive serotonin in the body, like serotonin toxicity, it's going to affect the patient. The patient may manifest symptoms like high blood pressure, hyperreflexia, agitation, restlessness. So this is a medical emergency. So you need to take note of this word, serotonin syndrome. It can result from taking St. John's Wort with antidepressant. Also, if a patient is taking St. John's Wort and also taking alcohol, it can result to CNS depression. So you may see a question that says a patient is taking St. John's Wort and patient also report taking alcohol. What is your priority assessment? So your priority assessment has to do with CNS because it can cause CNS depression. So you'll be checking that level of consciousness. Next one is salt palmetto. This medication is used for benign prostatic hyperplasia, BPH. But you should know that this medication can increase bleeding, especially when given an anticoagulant like warfarin. So that's all you need to know about salt palmetto. Now the next one is garlic. Garlic is used for lowering cholesterol, but it can lead to increased bleeding, especially when given with medication like anticoagulant. The next one is valeria. It's used for sleep disorder. So help you remember this valeria. Think about valium. So valium, something to calm yourself and help you sleep. So that's how I remember this valeria. So it's for sleep disorder, but you need to know that it can cause CNS depression with alcohol. That's all you need to know about valeria. If you are finding value in this video and you've not subscribed, please go ahead, hit the subscribe button and also leave your comments. Now, the next one is Echinacea is used for wound healing. Important you need to know about this is that it should not be used in immunocompromised patients because it could decrease the T cell function. And then we have Carver. This one is used for depression, just like St. John's Wort. Now, the important you need to know about Carver is that it can increase Parkinson's symptoms. So a patient that has Parkinson's disease, and of course, is taking levodopa, and the patient now reports taking Carver, you should know as a nurse that it can increase that Parkinson's symptoms. So it will worsen the ability to initiate and coordinate movements. The next one is ginseng. So ginseng boosts energy. It also supports mental status and supports immune function. Now, the important thing you need to know about ginseng is that it can affect blood sugar. It can reduce metformin levels. Then we have feverfew. This one is used for, as the name goes, fever is one of them. It's used to treat fever. It's used to treat headache, migraine, arthritis, menstrual pain, anything that has to do with pain and fever. That's what this feverfew is used for. Important thing you need to know about feverfew is that it can increase bleeding when given together with NSAIDs, with antiplatelet, with anticoagulant. And then finally, we have ginger. Ginger is used, of course, it's for treating nausea, vomiting, all those motion sickness, indigestion. They use ginger, but it can also increase bleeding with anticoagulant, antiplatelet, NSAID. So if you look at this medication, hypermedication, you say, oh Lord, but there's something common with most of them. If you look at the genes, the garlic, the ginger, the Ginkgo biloba, and also salt, palmetto, feverfew, you will see that increased risk of bleeding, especially when given with medication like anticoagulant, antiplatelet, and the NSAIDs. So these are, that should give you a clue. And also, if you notice, it also interacts with a lot of medication, especially St. John's Wort. It interacts with a lot of medication. So that will be a teaching point for you. When you see the necklace, you know you are assessing, either you are assessing the patient or you are teaching the patient. So that wraps up today's topic on herbal medication. If you find this video useful, please like this video, share this video with others that need it, subscribe to this channel, and leave your comment. Thanks for watching.